Up the tree?
Bound to hit the reef.
Is everything okay? I gave my report to the Admiral. Apparently, some of the crew have called for me to be stripped of rank and cast out. I'm so sorry, Seika. That must be really hard to take. It doesn't matter. Where are we headed next?
Well, we know where Londra sent the data from his old company. Somewhere on the mainland, north of where we met. Should be able to fly there.
Yeah, about that. Let's take my skiff this time instead.
Not a fan of flying, huh?
I'm a Marine. I'll take the water over the skies any day.
All right. We'll take your skiff.
Should we get going?
Yeah, let's go.
Follow me. Nice and easy. And, unlike flying, if you fall off, you don't die. Open water ahead, and fleet's end disappearing behind us, along with everyone in it.
Why do you put up with them? I mean, I get what it's like to feel as if an entire tribe's against you. I would have stormed out of there a long time ago.
It wasn't always like this. I was a good Marine. A good sister. Felt like I belonged. That belonging is a kind of strength. One that keeps me going even in the roughest seas. When you have something like that, you can't cast it aside.
I see. You know, your people don't know how lucky they are to have you.
I don't know about that.
I do. Well, seems like the port hits are leading us towards that horse.
That thing gives me the creeps. On clear nights, we can see it from the camp looming over us. On the shore! More of our boats!
Then we're on the right track.
I'll take us in!
Okay. The coordinates point to somewhere up the hill.
After you. Definitely seems like we're heading for the Metal Devil. Why would Londra send his data here?
I'm not sure. It's an odd place to bring a bunch of Quen, too.
I just hope we find them. My people were here, all right. Looks like they headed further up the hill.
coordinates lead that way, too.
Look! On the Meadow Devil's arm!
Laundra was definitely here.
What's it doing?
I'm not sure.
Got a couple of our big ugly friends, too. Ugh! And more eggs.
Just follow my lead.
Take them off!
Alice first.
Good. Better.
Thank you.
I'll keep some extra on hand. I could get a ride on that updraft if I use the shield wing. Tech.
There's no sign of my people here. We should head to the coordinates. Let's get this done! I'll wait here for you!
Take your time! I'll keep them busy!
Shall we continue?
Landra must have set it up.
Doesn't look like there's a way past it.
There's some kind of device on the other side. I think I can scan it.
You okay?
All right. Let's see what's on this thing.
It looks like there's something further in.
Some kind of compound. Landra might be in there. You're missing people, too.
I'm not seeing a way past the barrier.
There. It's some kind of power generator. Hooked up to the arm of the Horus. Landra's figured out how to get part of it working again.
A metal devil can't actually wake up, can it?
I'm not sure. But at least right now, it must be how Landra's powering the barrier.
So if we can find a way to shut down those generators, it should come down.
It's worth a shot, at least. Looks like there are two of them nearby. Come on, let's get going. We need to get to that Zenith tech we saw back down the hill.
Guess now we know what they were for.
That hunter killer in his trouble.
Lead on. Curious to see your approach.
Thank you.
Let's see if we can shut this thing down. Some kind of power core. I can't hit the core on my own. Stay here. I need you to shoot the core.
Got it!
One down. Now for the other generator.
Are in there. You know, the last time I saw my sister, I was relieved she was leaving for a scouting mission. I guess I wanted a break from her.
I get it. Things aren't always easy with my sister, either.
I thought you said you were an outcast.
I only met her recently. It's a long story.
Always full of surprises, huh?
I try. Point is, I'm sure your sister will be glad to see you.
I don't know. But it's nice of you to say.
It worked! Barrier's gone!
Let's head in. Looks like this place still has some power.
Generators must have just been for the shield.
People. And another mural.
Yeah. Why are they all just waiting?
Let's find out.
Have you come to join us?
Join you?
Yeah, we have. It took a while, but we finally made it.
A barbarian, one of the chosen. Impossible. Zeth would never allow this.
Hmm. How did you get in without him?
Well, Zeth sent us, actually. After we helped him out of that, that ambush in the wilds.
Right! You see, I was on my way here with him when machines attacked us. We tried to hold them off, but we were outnumbered. That's when Aloy here came to the rescue.
I was exploring the region when I ran across them, so I just rushed in to help.
You should have seen her. One of the best machine hunters I've ever met. She saved Zeth's life.
Oh, I was just doing what I could.
Zeth had something important he needed to take care of after, so he said to go on without him.
And that's when he told us how to lower the barrier and said we should head straight inside.
Zeth really needed a barbarian to get him out of trouble.
We all need a little supporting fire every now and then.
Well, Zeth gave them the okay. And I am not risking one of his outbursts. Let the others inside know about our new arrivals, will you?
Fine. But I'm not letting them into the Ascension Hall until they prove they're devoted, just like everyone else. And I'll be interested to hear Zeth's side of this when he returns.
Oh, by all means.
Don't mind him. Good luck in there, Seika. May you both embrace his light. I hope we'll greet the Ascension together.
I can't believe my people are here willingly. And the answer to Zeth!
Yeah, he sounds like a great guy.
Let's get to this Ascension Hall before you have to meet him.
A hologram of Blondra.
Welcome, my chosen. You have wandered, you have suffered, but you are lost no more. For I have found you. And I offer you what you deserve. The Ascension. So be at ease. Forget what you think you know. And embrace this moment. A new world awaits.
Okay. Ew, that's a lot of wonder.
So he wants us to embrace his light. Literally.
We'd better keep up appearances in here.
I'll try.
I'd like you to meet some old friends of mine. See, we were at the best party in town, celebrating our big win. And while everyone's attention was on me, my ex-business partner, well, he barges in, and he's jealous of our success, and he throws a drink in my face, but not a drop hit me, because my bodyguard, Jack, he tackled him to the floor, and the others, Riley and Nolan and Parker, well, they made sure he was kicked out, but it was my Evelyn who encouraged everyone to just laugh it off. I adored them. Their dedication to me meant everything more than any award. And it ended up being the best night of my life.
I guess Laundra's used to people worshipping him.
Gross.
Benevolence, I bet.
I've never seen such a spread.
Come, Sit with me.
Oh, good. This guy again.
I'd like to tell you a story. Once, I had a home on this world with the most beautiful view of the city. Me and my wife, we used to love to sit and watch the city lights twinkle in the evening haze. It's our moment of serenity. But then, the time of ashes came. And while the heavens offered an escape, only I survived and grasped the secrets of immortality. Evelyn, everyone I ever cherished, they were gone. And I was alone. Which is why I am so glad to have met you. Soon, you and I shall spend eternity on a new world. Every sunset. Together.
I'd rather sail into another typhoon than spend an eternity with him.
Take a moment, don't be shy.
Be the ones Brennick mentioned. Two more souls chosen to leave our thankless old life behind.
Yes, that is us.
It's Kiral, right? You were stationed on the Spark?
In my former life, yes. Just one more Marine bound to a hopeless expedition. Ugh. Enough of that. As Walter says, we must forget the past. Our suffering led us here after all. And now, the Ascension is almost upon us. This place is such a wonder, isn't it?
I've never seen anything like it.
Oh, but it is still nothing compared to what's in the Ascension Hall.
You've been inside?
Indeed. I proved my devotion not long before you joined us. Now I wait to be taken to what lies ahead. One step closer to the Ascension.
You mentioned you're waiting for what lies ahead, and we're still getting up to speed, but I thought the Ascension Hall was where we needed to go.
You're not the first to fail to grasp Walter's plan for us. Now that I've seen what's in the hall, my rank is secure. But there is something more that he's offering us. I just know it. It has to be why the devoted are escorted to another place. And as soon as Zeth returns, he'll take me there. I'm ready.
Do you have any idea where this place is, exactly?
Somewhere that brings us closer to Walter. To his embrace.
So you've been inside the Ascension Hall. Is it as special as we think it is?
I shouldn't say. I wouldn't want to deny you the same experience I had.
Come on, Kiral. Just a hint? We're dying to know what's inside.
I'll tell you this. It's breathtaking. Like the moment Walter first appeared before our boat, but better. Prove your devotion, and you'll see.
Well, thanks for talking with us, Kiral. We should get back to learning about Walter.
Yes, of course. Good luck with your studies. I hope to see you at the Ascension.
Well, if it isn't our do-gooder, and the barbarian.
It all makes sense now. The time of ashes? The floods in the Great Delta? We've been trapped in a cycle of destruction, but soon we'll have a new world.
That's quite a promise.
And now that you've proved your devotion, you're ready for what comes next. Zeth will lead you there as soon as he returns. Not so fast. Your good deed in the wilds may have gotten you this far, but you'll get no special treatment here. Walter himself granted me the privilege of guarding the Ascension Hall. So until you complete your review and learn the words of attainment, this door remains shut. No exceptions.
Okay, we will be back later then.
Sounds like we're supposed to pass some kind of laundry devotion test.
But who knows how long we have before this Zeth guy gets back. There's gotta be a faster way to learn whatever the words of attainment are. Let's take a look around.
Don't think the words were in those Laundra holograms we watched.
They might help with talking to the others.
That's not
nice.
We
could convince them to give us a hand.
I'd be reprimanded.
I'll get us a drink. In the meantime, remember what Walter said about embracing the future.
Seems like you don't really share your friend's excitement about all this.
I should be more excited, shouldn't I?
It's okay to question things.
Lam was thrilled when we got into the Ascension Hall. He can't wait to see what we'll be taking next, but I'm worried that all of this is too good to be true.
So why don't you just leave?
I can't abandon him. We've been through everything together. Our missions, the typhoon, the shipwreck. And soon, the Ascension, I guess.
Seems like most of the Quen are more than happy to follow Laundra. So why not you?
At first, I wanted to believe. Everything he told us felt like it filled an emptiness. Like maybe I'd finally found somewhere to belong. Then I remembered how the boards back home would tell us to follow the virtues of the legacy, to be good and honest. And then they dragged my father away for speaking out against an imperial decree. I'm not sure it's any different here. Walter might be a living ancestor, but with a cudgel like Zeth to do his bidding, his kindness is just as conditional as the Empire's.
As far as anyone at your settlement knows, you went out into the wilds and vanished. How did you end up here?
Lon and I were part of a scouting mission to the mainland, but things went bad fast. We were lost and starving, our boat was wrecked, and then Walter found our camp. A living ancestor, emerging from the wilds to tell us we'd been chosen, that we were safe. It was easy to embrace. Everyone here has a similar story.
Why didn't anyone send word to us?
Not everyone is chosen. Walter says we must leave our old lives behind if we're going to ascend. Nobody questioned it. But I should have.
You said Lon can't wait to see where you're headed next. Do you know what you'll find there?
I imagine it'll be another kind of test, like here. Once you've been in the Ascension Hall, you're taken there by Zeth. He and his troops are the only ones who ever come back.
Everyone keeps mentioning him. I get the feeling he's not really a friendly guy.
As friendly as a Fireclaw. But it's not just him. The soldiers that follow him are like that too. I guess they know they can do as they like, now that they don't answer to the Admiral or compliance.
You're right to be skeptical of all this. Wanderer's up to something. We need to get into the Ascension Hall to figure out what. And to do that, we need the Words of Attainment.
I don't want to stir up any trouble. When Zeth comes back, he'll figure out that I told you.
Does it have something to do with one of those Laundra displays?
This is important, Otosu. A lot of lives are at stake.
It's related to what Walter said he valued most about his friends.